This land is your land, and this land is my land. From California to the New York Island, from the Redwood Forest to the Gulf Stream waters, this land was made for you and me.
Hello again, this is Geoff, and welcome back to this short podcast series. This will be the third episode so far. And if you have not had a chance to check out the first two, feel free. The focus of those were on the origins of the student farm. And then the second was talking about the student farm club and ways to get involved through that. So we're going to keep things rolling here today with the third. We have Morali here.
Hello.
The goal for this podcast is going to be talking about ways to volunteer on the student farm. And kind of like I mentioned last time, part of this podcast and the reasoning for doing it is to get the word out there about the student farm, ways to get involved, as many people have had great experiences, so just sharing that message so that people who might be interested have the opportunity to do so. So as I said, today Morali is our guest, and she's a freshman studying biological engineering and has been volunteering on the farm for two semesters now.
That's right.
So great to have you.
Thanks, great to be here.
So could you tell us about the first time that you volunteered at the student farm?
Well, I'd signed up with the farm, but I hadn't made it to many of the club meetings. So I looked at the website and realized I could go out. I could sign up and go out any morning that I had time. So I just put my name down and biked out to the farm one morning, and I got a chance to help weed and harvest some of the crops they were growing that fall. So it was a great break from classes. And I'm glad I did it because it gave me a new interest for the rest of the semester.
Awesome. But it kept you coming back, is that right?
It definitely
did. You came
did.
Back multiple times.
Yes, it did.
Is that right?
Once or twice a week for most of October. Once I'd gotten started, I kept wanting to come back.
She's hooked. So be careful. If you do volunteer on the farm, you might keep coming back.
Once they get you, you're stuck.
Yeah, so just be careful with that. Okay, so what are some of the jobs that you've done volunteering on the farm?
Well, it was toward the end of the season when I finally got there, so a lot of it was weeding, but it wasn't. It was even that was a little different from what I'm used to. It wasn't down your hands and knees weeding. We got to use these interesting tools I hadn't seen before and weed from standing up, and it went pretty fast. We also did some composting, pulled out some plants, and toward the end of the season we covered over some of the rows so they could survive the winter with some sandbags and some tarps.
Right, so it sounds like quite the array of tasks.
Yeah, I joined right in with the interns, so yeah. Whatever the farm was going on the farm that day was what I was doing.
And if you heard her, she said you can weed while standing up. Now, I don't know about you guys, but that is a rarity, okay? Weeding is a back-breaking work, but you can weed standing up. So.
Now, that's progress.
Yeah, that's progress. That's if there's one reason, that's why you might want to consider volunteering. Okay, and then can anybody volunteer? Like, do you need any prior experience? Did you have any prior knowledge?
I certainly didn't have any. I did some gardening at home for a few years, but I know nothing about farming. But I gave it a try, and the interns were always willing to help me out, so I learned as I went, and it was a great experience.
Nice. And then you said that you would bike there each time, is that right?
Yeah. The student farm is actually in a really nice location in the back of the arboretum, so you can bike through some woods, which were great in the fall, and park your bike at the farm and get to work. It's only about 20 minutes from campus.
20 minutes. And it's pretty fast going downhill, right?
Yes, the way there, it's nice downhill.
Yeah.
The way up is a bit slow, not too bad.
But we won't talk about the way up. Okay. And was it hard to sign up, or did you have to just kind of, like, what was that process like?
The sign-up is just online. They have a calendar up there. You can sign up for a time slot with however many people you want to bring, and that's all it takes.
Okay, so it's pretty easy. Okay, interesting. You're studying biological engineering.
That's right.
Engineering. Everybody hear that? Engineering. But she's still volunteering at the student farm. So they seem kind of separate, but in some way, has this been a good way to maybe diversify your college experience, or kind of a way to take study breaks or.
Yeah, it's. I'm glad I'm not always doing math and physics and engineering. Yeah, so the farm actually made me change my major a little bit, because my original engineering major was very chemistry industry oriented. And once I got started volunteering with the farm, I kind of pulled out of that and realized there were all these opportunities in agriculture. So I moved into biological engineering, which is actually, it's closer to agriculture and natural resource engineering. So the work on the farm is pretty close to the work I might be doing. So working on the farm has actually inspired me to move on with that and make that more my career.
Huh. That's very, very profound. And as you were saying earlier, just before this podcast started, Morali is going to be working on the student farm for an honors option class.
Yes.
And was it looking at different soil tests? Was
yes.
that right?
Yeah, I'm doing an honors option with my soil science class. I'm actually doing soil tests on the student farm and the area around it to try and see what organic farming can do to the soil to change its health. So it's been pretty exciting to learn that hands-on instead of just out of my soils textbook.
Right, right. And I guess that kind of gets into the, experiential learning component, which, you know, that along with the building friendships, connecting with the outdoors are kind of our three themes for this podcast. But like you said, the experiential learning, getting out there, working with the soil and seeing that yourself has got to be a pretty rewarding experience.
Yeah, and the farm is pretty encouraging about that. I talked to Leslie, the advisor, and she was open to me doing this honors option project at the beginning of the semester, so it took off.
Mm-hmm. Very cool. So with your classes, you know, engineering, you're probably spending a lot of time studying, and that could be inside, you know, at times or outside, but
yeah.
Maybe, you know, being at the farm, being outside, being with nature, how has that been for you?
It's given me some perspective, because I can get kind of feel like I'm stuck, glued to my books during the day, but when I can get out to the farm and work with my hands for a while, it lets me come back to my classes a little calmer and focus a little better, because I know this isn't everything I'm going to do. I have a chance to get away every once in a while.
Right. So it sounds like it's kind of a way to ground yourself and keep you calm, keep you motivated maybe to keep studying.
Definitely.
Can be a good study break. And maybe what's one unique experience you've had volunteering on the farm, if you can think of one time that you've enjoyed?
Well, last semester, at the end of the growing season, the student farm had this event called Gleanings, where they just said, come out to the farm and pick the vegetables we have left. So I biked out there, and because it was the end of the semester, I planned out a meal I could cook for my family back home, and I just picked the vegetables I needed and came back with two or three big bags of them.
Mm-hmm. And it could be any vegetables, you never even know. I think one time I was out there and I came back with a pound of parsley. And I just
ate a pound of parsley.
I just ate parsley for the whole day. So you never know what you could get. So are there any final thoughts or final takeaways that you'd like to share with people who might be interested in volunteering?
Just give it a try and see if you like it. It's you can give just an hour and you might find that you always want to come back, just like I do.
Yeah, I think it's a good point where, you know, volunteering, it's very much just go one time if you like it, and you can stay as long or as little as you might choose. And you might go and you might end up waiting for 2 hours and be like, okay, this isn't for me. And that's perfectly fine. But
you might wind up waiting for 2 hours and realize that waiting can be fun.
Yes, maybe, yeah.
Maybe not.
Yeah, but regardless, you know, it can be a good experience, something outside of the everyday life, and a good way to get more involved with the Penn State community.
Yeah.
So thank you, Morali, for talking with us today.
Thank you.
So if you are interested in volunteering, if this is something that's piqued your interest, check out the Student Farm website, and if you scroll over to the Get Involved tab, and then click on volunteer, there will be a variety of time slots available, and you can just hit one of those and say how many people you're bringing, and you can go from there. So come as you please, and once again, the listserv link will be posted below if you'd like to receive any updates about the Student Farm Club and some of the activities that are going on throughout the week. So thank you for listening, and take care.